BeCozi.com is here. Today I would like to show you how to make a jumbo Chenille blanket. This is our blanket that we'll be making today. The blanket is done with our jumbo white and gray colors. Look at this beautiful pattern. Isn't it nice? And it also looks very cute on the back. So this is the back of the blanket. So it's kind of like looking really nice if you wanna use it on this side. So it's kind of both sides usable blanket, really beautiful. It's very soft, it's very thick and warm, and it's made with our gray color and white color jumbo Chenille. Jumbo Chenille yarn is available only at BeCozi.com, guys. It's not available at any craft store, so after watching this video, you can click on the link on the bottom of the video, or there is also a clickable link on the right spot, right from you in the top corner. You can click, go directly to our website and order this beautiful blanket. It's available only at BeCozi.com in the United States. And it's very thick, fluffy, it's washable, it's children and pets friendly, and it's super warm and beautiful for making blankets, hand knitting blankets. So if you have our yarn ready, again, jumbo Chenille yarn from BeCozi, and we will need, guys, 7 skeins for this size. This size is about 34 inches wide and about 48 inches long, so it's kind of like a small blanket. It's enough to cover your legs when you're sitting on the couch. Again, 7 skeins, and I will be using 4 skeins of gray and 3 skeins of white. So if you have the yarn ready, let's get started. Okay, guys, let's get started. So we will be using this 2 beautiful colors, gray jumbo Chenille and white. You can see the name on the back, gray and white. So if you see some labels still saying chunky and this one saying jumbo, it's just a mistake. I'm sorry for some skeins like that we have. If you see that it's the same thickness, it is jumbo. You can easily see the difference between chunky and jumbo Chenille, because jumbo is much, much thicker and fluffier. So what we will do, guys, we will start with gray color. We will find the end of the yarn. Now we will make a knot on the end like that, then pull it, and then cut the tail close to the knot. This way we will prevent yarn from unraveling. There might be some yarn falling off the end, so you need to shake it like that and get rid of this little pieces of yarn. So what do I do now? We're placing yarn in front of us like that. Then we're placing this is working yarn, this is tail. Working yarn goes on the top like that. You just made a loop, and now insert your hand inside this loop, grab working yarn and pull it out. We just made our first stitch, and we will pull working yarn down to make it a little bit smaller. So we'll keep it about 1.5 inches, maybe between 1.5 and 2. So what we are doing now? So now we will be making a chain, and the chain will be 16 or 17 stitches, depending how tight you are knitting. So insert your hand inside this first stitch, grab working yarn and pull it out. We just made second stitch, and now we will be holding this stitch on the bottom with our left hand. Insert your right hand, grab working yarn, pull it out. We just made stitch number 3. Move your hand, hold the bottom of the stitch, and then insert your hand, grab working yarn and pull it out. 4. Keep doing the same way until you have you cast on a chain of 16 stitches, guys. We will do 16 stitches. Again, if you're knitting tighter, you will need to add one stitch and start with 17 stitches for the size 30, the width 30. Let's count the stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here we are. We have 16 stitches chain. What we will be doing now, we will turn this chain on another side. We will flip it over like that. We are doing it because we will be using this middle part of the stitch, this knots in the middle. It's kind of hard to see on the Jumbo Chenille yarn, so be very careful because we are not knitting the top part of the stitch or bottom, we're knitting this middle part. First of all, we will need to knit this first stitch. So I will insert my hand from inside, grab working yarn, pull it out. So this will be our first stitch. Now we will find this knot. This is the middle part of this stitch, not top, not bottom. And we will lift it and then insert our hand, grab working yarn and pull it out. Have two stitches. Now find the next knot. See, you can see those knots. And then pull it out like that. So that's what we will be doing with this first row. We will be pulling out the stitches with our gray yarn. So what are we doing now, guys? We are taking our white color, making a knot on the end, then pull and cut the tail close to the end or to the knot. Now we will be knitting this white color now. So place it on the back of this first row that we knitted. So this is our gray color and this is our white. You're simply starting and knitting the white color. Insert your hand, grab working yarn and pull it out. Now do the same, insert your hand, grab working yarn, pull it out. So we will be making this simple knitting stitch all the way through this row, and then we will switch back to the gray color. So it's very simple pattern, guys, but combination of this beautiful very thick and fluffy Jumbo Chenille yarn that is available only at BeCozi.com in United States. You will not find this yarn anywhere else, no craft stores, no other places have it. And now we will be knitting our second row. Okay, guys, so we're done with our first white row. So we have two rows of gray, and now we are skipping the first stitch over here and we're going into the second one. Why I'm skipping the first? Because it will give us a beautiful chain on the side. It will look like this chain on the bottom. So we are inserting our hand inside the second stitch, grab working yarn, pull it out. Next one. And keep doing this way until you are done knitting the whole row, and then it will look really beautiful and we will go back to our gray color. Here we are. So now we are not making any connections here. I mean, we're not cutting yarn, we're simply going back to this gray yarn. Okay, so we will put it underneath the white and on the back like that. And now we will simply insert our hand, grab working yarn and pull it out. So you can see that I will be skipping And then we will just simply knit the next row. I will be skipping knitting the first stitch when I'm knitting the same color, and I will be knitting the first stitch when we are switching color. I hope it makes sense. If you don't want to get confused, just knit all first stitches in this pattern. Here we are. This is our first row. Now we are making the second row, and as I said, this is the same color, so I'm skipping this stitch and I am simply knitting the next row. Here we are. So now we are going back to our white, and gray goes on the bottom, white goes on the top. This way, see, we are not cutting any yarn, we're not connecting any yarn, we're just simply going from one color to another. So now we're going with the white color, and we're simply knitting our white yarn, making a simple knitting stitch. So that's the whole pattern, guys. It's very easy, but it looks amazingly beautiful on a blanket because it's a beautiful color combination, gray and white. And just two simple row of each color, and it will be pretty fast project because you don't need to do any connections. So this is the same color. I am skipping the first stitch and I'm going directly to the second, and I am simply knitting. I will show you one more gray color, and then I will just keep knitting and come back to show you how to cast off. Here we are. So again, white goes on the bottom, gray goes on the top. Simply insert your hand, because it's a different color, we're not skipping first stitch, and then simply knit the first stitch. Here we are. You already see this beautiful pattern is coming out, and Jumbo Chenille is super soft and beautiful. You will love it. If you never used it before, you should definitely give it a try. It's amazing yarn. It's my favorite. It's easy to knit and it's easy to take care of. So we're skipping first stitch because it's the same color, and we are knitting our next row. So that's pretty much all for this pattern, guys, and we will keep alternating two rows gray, two rows white, and then I will come back and I will show you how to finish this beautiful blanket. Okay guys, so I'm done with the first skein of gray. So what I will need to do, I will need to connect the second skein, and I want you to see how I'm doing it. I'm making a simple knot and then tie it, and making it tight, you just pull it both directions gently, not to break the yarn, but then you will feel that it doesn't go any farther. Then you are cutting the tail on both sides close to the yarn, and that's how it looks. So you pretty much don't even see it on the finished blanket because Jumbo Chenille is very soft and fluffy. So, and then we will just keep doing our pattern. And then I will come back and I will show you how to finish. Okay guys, so we are ready to cast off. You can see that I made two last rows in gray, and now I have enough yarn to cast off. For casting off, we're simply taking two stitches at the same time, then grabbing working yarn and pulling it through two stitches. Then keep your hand inside this last stitch, add another stitch, you now have two, grab working yarn, pull it through. So you're simply knitting two stitches at a time. Try to make this stitch a little bit bigger than the one on the blanket. This way you will make the top of your blanket not narrower than the bottom. So this one should be a little bit on the looser side. This way it will look the same as the bottom. So keep knitting two stitches at a time until you are all the way to the end of the blanket. Here we are. We are to the last stitch. Here we are. We have one last stitch left over here. What we are doing? We are cutting our yarn about 8 inches, 5/8 inches, make a knot on the end. Oh, broke it. Okay, making a knot. And it's broken again. So when it happens, try to not to pull hard. So cut the tail and now insert this tail inside the last stitch and pull it. So that's what we have. Now this tail can go on the back of any stitch like that. And you will not really see it because it's very fluffy. So what we need to do, we need to cut the white yarn here on the side, make a knot, and to hide the make the knot to cut the tail and hide this in between the stitches. That was the yarn that we were using for our white lines, like that. And now we will do the same on the bottom of the blanket. We have two pieces here, see? I will make a knot with them, connecting white and gray. And then I will cut this tails close to the knot. Here we are. We connected all the ends. And again, if you want to get rid of these little pieces, you can pinch them out or just shake the blanket when it's ready. So here we are, guys. Look at this beautiful, beautiful blanket. And we used it. This is the back of the blanket, by the way. It looks kind of cool too, so you can use it on this side or on this side. See how different it is. And now we can so we used 7 skeins. We used 4 skeins of gray and 3 skeins of white, because we have bottom, so it was a little bit more of the gray color than the white. So Jumbo Chenille is available at BeCozi.com. You can find 25 colors we have available. Save on my BeCozi. So guys, don't forget, my book is ready to purchase. BeCozi.com, Amazon, Kindle, ebook, and this is the best gift for upcoming Christmas for yourself or for your loved one.